Yo, welcome to Containing Luxury. On this episode, we would like to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving and request a little bit of thankful giving. Let's get started. So everyone knows we're building container homes on this channel. What you may or may not know, if you've been following us, I'm also a general contractor. And part of my general contracting duties is we work with investors, we acquire properties, and we sometimes flip houses or we buy distressed properties, we renovate them, and then we will put them back on the market, or we will rent them, hold them for a while, and then put them back on the market. So there's a lot of moving facets as to any construction and being tied in with real estate. Now, with that being said, a lot of time we don't actually meet the people that when we acquire a house or an investor acquires a house, it sometimes is gone already to the bank. And by the time we get it, it's just filled with a bunch of, you know, remnants of the people that lived there before, you know, whether it's garbage and furniture or whatever it is. Most of the time we don't actually ever meet the people. In some rare cases, like recently, I went to go explore a house that some wholesale guys acquired this property. It's going through foreclosure. I've got an investor that wanted to go in with me, and we were gonna acquire the property at a great price. We're gonna renovate the whole thing and put it back on the market. So we wanted to try and get in and view the property before we close on it. So we drove out there, we got access to the property, and turns out I actually know the people that are, I guess, losing the house to the bank, and then these wholesale guys are buying the property or negotiating a contract for us to buy the property right before it goes through foreclosure. So it saves them from a foreclosure. We run into this family yesterday. It turns out I know them. I feel really, you know, awkward in the whole deal because here I am, a guy coming in to acquire this property. I don't really want to embarrass them. So I just kind of say, hey, look, I'm just a contractor. You know, I try to just get in and out of the house as much as possible. There's not too much inside of a house that really matters to me because, you know, we can gut anything. We're a contractor. We have all the tools. We have all the guys. So there's nothing major I really needed to see in there. I'd rather just make it less awkward for them and get out of the house. So I called the wholesale guys and I said, hey, look, it turns out I know this family. And I know, you know, some other members of their family, and they're somewhat tied into the construction industry. I don't want to give too many facts. I'm not going to use any names. I called the wholesale guy and I'm like, hey, look, you know, we want to be ethical on this. I know these people, they're super nice. It's not like, you know, they're not destroying the house. They, you know, just got themselves into a bind and they're really nice people. They're not asking for any handouts. And he agreed. So he was like, you know what? We're trying to help to find them a place, but they won't accept any assistance. So yesterday, as I'm driving away, I called the investor that, you know, I'm partnering with on this deal. And I said, hey, look, you know, there are some Christian guys. We're Christian guys. And the wholesale guys are Christian guys. So it's like, hey, let's do something ethical and let's try and help these people. It's not the stereotypical way that these deals go down. And more than making money, we want to make sure that we can at least, you know, do this as ethical as possible and find a replacement place for these people to live in, especially we're at Thanksgiving. So I jumped online last night. South Florida is really expensive. I know where she works. I know where the family works. So I'm trying to pick a place in a close proximity to there because I think her son was driving her back and forth to work. So we're putting him out of his way, you know, all this different stuff. So I found a great apartment. I think we're gonna be in the range between $1,100 to $1,200 a month. And down here in Florida, we have to cover first, last, and security. So let's use $1,200 times three is gonna be $3,600. So we have to come up with $3,600 to just get them into a place. So I wanted to reach out to all the subscribers, anyone that's chiming in on our channel. Everybody's been super grateful. You know, we try to do everything we can. The whole purpose of our channel is to give out free information, to give advice on how people can, you know, live inexpensively, you know, how we can help people, how we can use the systems that we're designing, you know, to help solve, you know, homeless issues, help solve, you know, the issues in the Bahamas, so many different things that we're using this channel for. So I figured, what better community to reach out? We're gonna start a GoFundMe. We're gonna post a link in the description, and just to help us raise some money. So just so you guys know, I will be paying this 100% out of my pocket if we get no one helping us. So anything that you guys feel that you wanna throw in, then that will go 100% directly to this person's rent. I would love that if we could raise enough money to pay an entire year's worth of their rent. Because if they're in this situation that they, you know, are losing their house, well, maybe they just need to catch back up and get a little bit of a head start so that maybe they can afford to buy an expensive car so that her son can go back to work and not have to drive and commute her back and forth. So anything that we raise in this, if we raise, you know, $20,000, that's all gonna go to them. But I haven't discussed any of this with them. They don't know anything that's going on. This is just something that we're closing on December 10th on their house. So I have until then to acquire the place and get it paid for. And I should learn by now that my phone is always ringing. I should silence it. All right, so anyway, that's what's going on. You know, Thanksgiving, holiday time. We feel really bad going in and being investors. And, you know, here we are generating income doing this kind of stuff. And these people are losing their homes. So we want to reach out to community. Anything you guys can do to help would be greatly appreciated. And we're going to share what happens with this and anything we do. So make sure to check in or chime into the community section. We'll be sharing more facts on that. Whether or not we make another video, I don't know. We'll find out. Thank you guys, and happy Thanksgiving. And we will see you on the next one.